Hello students, welcome all of you. I am Leela Jadhav from KTHM College, Nashik. Today I am going to discuss with you about the first chapter, that is Accounting Standards and Financial Reporting, means Introduction to International Financial Reporting Standards. Therefore, today I am going to discuss in my lecture Accounting Standard number 15. Name of this standard is Employees Benefits 2005. Accounting Standard 15, Employees Benefits 2005. This standard deals with accounting for retirement benefits in the financial statements of employers. For this purpose, the retirement benefits considered may be in the form of provident fund, superannuation or pension, gratuity, leave encashment benefits on retirement, post-retirement, health and welfare scheme, and any other retirement benefits. Accounting Standard 15 has been revised by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and is applicable in respect of accounting period commencing on or after 1st April 2006. The scope of the accounting standard has been enlarged to include accounting for short-term employee benefits and termination benefits. Further, the detailed principles for the retirement benefits have also been laid down. And then we see the meaning. Employees' benefits are also form of consideration given by an enterprise directly to the employee or their spouse, children or other dependents, or to others such as trust, insurance companies, in exchange of service rendered by the employee. Who is an employee? For the purpose of this standard, employee includes whole-time directors and management personnel. The standard is applicable to all forms of employer-employees relationship. There is no requirement for a formal employees-employee relationship. Several factors need to be considered to determine the nature of relationship. Generally, outsourcing contractor may not meet the definition of employer-employees relationship. Applicability of this standard. Accounting Standard 15 is made applicable to different types of enterprises as under. Level 1 enterprises in this entirely. Other than level 1 enterprises, if average number of persons employed during the year is 50 or more, the accounting standard is applicable to such enterprises except the provision relating to recognition and measurement of short-term accumulating compensated absence, in respect of which employees are not entitled to cash payment for unused leave at the time of leaving the service. Next, discounting the amount payable after 12 months of balance sheet as regards defined contribution plans and termination benefits. Recognition, measurement and disclosure principles in respect of defined benefits plans and other long-term employee benefit plans. However, such enterprise should provide and disclose the accrued liability in respect of defined benefits plans and other long-term employees benefits plans as per actuarial valuation based on projected units, credit method and discount rate based on yield on government bonds. And then if average number of persons employed during the year is less than 50, such enterprise can determine and provide the liability and expenses as regard defined benefits plans and long-term employees benefits by assuming that such benefits are payable to all employees at the end of the accounting year, and therefore recognition, measurement and disclosure principles as laid down in this accounting standard in respect of defined benefits plans and long-term employees benefits will not apply to such enterprises. Types of employees benefits and overview of their accounting treatment. Employees benefit is, first one, short-term employees benefits such as wages, salaries and social security contributions, paid annual leave and paid sick leave, profit sharing and bonuses if payable within 12 months, and non-monetary benefits such as medical care, housing, car and free of subsidized goods or services for current employees. So this is the benefits. See the overview of this benefits accounting treatment. When an employee has rendered services in exchange for these benefits by debiting to expenses. And then second, post-employment benefits such as pensions, other retirement benefits, post-employment life insurance and post-employment medical care. So see the accounting overview of such benefits may be of defined contribution plans or defined benefit plans if covered by defined contribution plan. Contribution is recognized as an expenses. Contribution due on the date of balance sheet is treated as liability and excess paid is treated as asset. And the next, other long-term employees benefits including long service leave or sabbatical leave, jubilee or other long service benefits, long term disability if they are payable 12 months or more after the end of the period, profit sharing, bonuses and deferred compensation. The overview of accounting is legal and constructive obligation under the plan is calculated on actuarial valuation and is recognized as an expenses and defined liability, net or fair value of plan asset in the balance sheet. And the last, termination benefits including voluntary retirement benefits. Accounting treatment is termination benefits are recognized as an expenses immediately, however, where enterprise incur expenditure on termination benefits on or before 31st March 2009, it may choose to follow the accounting policy of deferring such expenditure over its payback period. This is the overview of employees benefits accounting. Lastly, I would like to give you a question for self-study which is important for our university exam. Question is, what are employees benefits as per Accounting Standard 15 and state the applicability of Accounting Standard 15. With this, I would like to say thank you. Thank you very much. Next lecture, we will start Accounting Standard number 17, Segment Reporting.